Hi, my name is Fergal and I am a Wella educator. And today I'm going to talk you through a Teasy lights technique. Teasy lights is where you want to lighten the hair in highlights and you would tease and backcomb the root section so you get a much softer transition of colour from the root into the ends. This is going to mean that we're going to avoid a harsh demarcation line. For the client, this means a much softer, more beautiful grow out. For the stylist, it means you can achieve a much higher level of lift than if you were to do a freehand painting technique. The benefit of doing a teasy light over freehand painting, for example, is that you can work an awful lot faster once you get your technique down. When you're painting freehand, you have to be quite exact about where your product is placed to make sure that you don't get any hard lines in it. Whereas by backcombing the root on a teasy light, this is going to give you that softer graduation of colour. Another benefit is that it is going to grow out an awful lot easier. So for the client, it means less regular visits to the salon. So as you can see on my model here, we did some teasy lights through the top section of her hair. Here, the transition from the root colour into those mid-lengths and ends is much softer than with a traditional highlight. And that's because we don't have that hard demarcation line. By backcombing the root area, it gives us a much, much softer graduation of colour. This also means that we can get lighter by isolating the hair. So when we're lightening it, we're going to use some clear wraps in between each section. That's going to help us to get more lift in there. So it's really suitable if you're trying to get a cool ombre, balayage or baby lights type of technique. The main benefits of a teasy light technique is that number one, once you get it down, you can work an awful lot faster than you would if you were doing freehand painting. The second benefit is you will achieve a lot more lift than if you were doing a freehand painting technique where you weren't isolating and insulating each section as you're working. The third benefit is that you're going to get a softer graduation from your root colour to your highlighted section. And then the benefits for a client means that they're going to have a much softer grow out and feel like they don't need to visit the salon as often to have their hair lightened. So there's three things that I need to consider when I am doing my teasy light section. The first thing is how thick or how thin is the slice that I'm first going to take. The second thing then is how big is my weave? Is it fine, medium or coarse? And the third thing is how much do I actually backcomb at the root? So when you're taking your section, if you take a section that is too thick, then you're going to have trouble actually getting the bleach to penetrate right through all the different layers of the hair. And that means you're going to get an uneven result. If the section that you take is too fine, then when you go to backcomb, you're not actually going to get a really nice graduation of colour because you won't have pushed enough hair away. So my rule of thumb is normally about a half inch thick section. Obviously this is going to depend on the type of hair that you're working with. So here we're going to take about a half inch section. The next thing you want to think about then is how thick or how thin do you want your weave to be. The chunkier the weave, the more definition you're going to see. So I like to work with chunkier weaves to the back of the head. Around the sides and at the top section, I like to work with a finer weave so I can get a much better blend. If you're not sure which one you want, stick to a medium weave for your first trial. Then when it comes to backcombing, so I'll get this weaved out first. When it comes to backcombing, deciding just how much you want backcombed. I like to hold the hair really, really gently between my thumb and my palm and push the excess hair away. Now, as you can see, it's all starting to gather up here. I normally do that 3 to 4 times. And then what I do is I pick up a sectioning grip and pop that in right up to the root. What this does is it helps me get my color as close to the root as possible, but while still avoiding a demarcation line. Now I'm going to show you what not to do, taking a section that is far too thick. So here we've got one that's about 2 inches thick. Then we'll do a really chunky weave again. and then we'll backcomb. So when we've backcombed here, we have all this hair kind of hanging out. But if we look at the underside, none of that there has been backcombed. So it means that we're not going to get that beautiful soft graduation of colour. There'll be a hard demarcation line, and there'll also be some warmer spots in it. So we need to take a slightly finer section when we are doing our Teasy light. Now, if I take a section that is far too fine, so I'm going to take a really, really fine slice here. And if I again do a chunky weave. So this is already quite fine. If I go too much, we've removed almost all of the hair and there's only a small bit left. So this is far too fine a section for us to work with, and it's going to give us an uneven result. So about a half inch thick section. For your weave, you can go, you know, fine, medium or coarse. I know I'm repeating myself, but I like to do finer kind of at the top and at the front just to give us a nicer blend. So I've taken that half inch section just there. I can still do a fine weave to get a really, really nice blend. But there's enough hair in this section for me to backcomb, so that in three or four pushes, and I take my grip and push that back up, I've got a really nice amount of hair that will work well with bleach. It means I'll get full saturation and a really great lift in there as well. So when it comes to your sectioning pattern, there is an unlimited number of different ways that you can section on the head. If you want something that shows off a little bit more colour definition, then I like to work horizontally. However, if you want to get a really, really nice blend in the hair, working diagonally helps to achieve that and to diffuse that demarcation line area. On this head here, I'm going to just section for a classic highlight section, so a rectangle on the top and then four sections through our back and sides, so we can see the way that I work and it's nice and clean for the viewer. Great, so we have sectioned our head off. We have a rectangle on top, our two side sections and our two back sections. Because the haircut here is kind of a long bob, or that mid-length haircut, I'm actually not gonna highlight the hair underneath for two reasons. The first one is a highlight is only a highlight when it has something else to sit on top of. So if I highlight right down to the bottom, it's all just going to look like one blonde kind of block. The second reason is hair tends to be that little bit more fragile around the underneath section on someone's hair. So I don't want to go over processing that section and causing any kind of unnecessary stress on the hair. So here we're going to start colouring around the occipital bone. So I've mixed up my favourite bleach, which is BlondorPlex, and we've also got our Welloxon 6%. Mixed the two of them in a 1 to 1.5 mixing ratio, and it gives us this really thick, creamy consistency. I can hold it over my head and it's not coming out. So it's absolutely perfect for freehand painting or for trying to design where exactly you want to put your product when you're working on a look like this. When you're working with Teasy lights, you want to make sure that you're not overloading the hair with lighter areas. I have left plenty of negative space or darker areas here to the back and sides to make sure that I still have some color definition, and that will make my lighter areas really pop, but I still have a beautiful blend. So to the top section, I'm here working from the back forward. The reason for this is this hairstyle is cut all to fall onto the face. So you want to colour it in the opposite direction that it falls to get the maximum blend. So taking a fine section from the back. I'm going to clip the rest out of my way. We're going to do quite a fine weave. Now, through the crown area to make sure that we don't get any kind of hard lines in there. When I'm back home, and I'm going to lift it straight up from the head. This is going to give me a little bit of lift and it's going to prevent any kind of hard line from forming. So holding it up from the head, I'm going to push down two or three times get my grip, secure it in there. I also want to make sure I can get as much of the lightness up as close to the root as possible. So really pushing that clip in. So before to the back and sides, I was painting straight into my hand. You can do this or you can paint onto the wrap or the foil, whichever you prefer. I like painting onto my hand because it means I can feel the colour and I know if the section is completely saturated. So painting right onto my hands. I'm then using my fingers to kind of smush it up, to blend it up towards the root area. I'm making sure that I got a really, really nice blend. Being careful not to get any bleach on the back comb area. In between, I am making sure that my hands are clean because if you've got product in your hands, it's almost impossible to pick these up. Getting it on there, cleaning my hands. Through the top section, I really want to make sure that the blend is really, really seamless. And you can't really see where the lighter areas begin or where the root has ended. So I'm taking much finer sections here. So we've coloured the full head using our Teasy Lights technique, getting the back combing in there on the roots, colouring the mid-lengths and ends then with our hands, making sure we've got plenty of colour on the hair and using our clear wraps to separate each section. Once this is developed, I'm going to take the model to the backwash. We're going to get it rinsed and we'll apply our Wellaplex number 2. And then after that, I'm going to show you how I remove the back combing section for the hair before I tone. So we've taken all the clear wraps out. We've given the hair a good rinse and we've applied our Wellaplex number 2. It's going to stay on there for 10 minutes. Now in those 10 minutes, I'm going to comb the hair out with a backwash brush, a wet brush, whatever you've got to hand that's going to be really, really gentle. The hair is in a bit of a fragile state. It's wet, it's just been bleached and the roots are back combed. So you want to take these 10 minutes while your Wellaplex is on to comb out the hair, try and get as much of that back combing or teasing out before we go and shampoo, antioxidize and then apply our toner afterwards as well. So I like to try and start removing the back combing and the combing process from the back of the head. It always seems to come out that little bit easier, as here the hair is just a little bit finer around the hairline. Then moving into the sides and finally finishing off at the top. So when you're trying to remove it, always start with the ends first, unraveling those, working up towards the roots and making sure each section has been combed out really, really well and there's no remaining knots before you get to the toning stage. So here you have the finished look. I've blow dried it straight today because straight hair always shows off mistakes and I want you to see that there have been absolutely no funny demarcation lines, no harsh highlights. It's just really, really soft, really beautiful. That gorgeous blend from the darker root into the lighter ends, just made possible by doing that little bit of a teasy light throughout. In total, I think I did maybe around 20 highlights altogether for the full head, but it's given this beautiful all over lightness that you can see. If you like today's video, make sure you like and subscribe to at Wella Hair on YouTube. If you've got any questions about anything I did or used, let us know in the comments below. And you can find me on Instagram at Fergal Wella.